If you want to know what troubles me, it is this. I listen to this story, and in the nights of the first day I see ourselves. Proud, noble warriors who came face to face with something in themselves that they couldn't accept. So they made a choice, a tragic one. Azrael set down his glass with a firm click. His face was growing hard again, with anger or suspicion, or both. And what tragic choice do you think we have made, my brother? You have already said that the Fallen are our monsters who must be destroyed. What mistake is there, then, that connects this story to them, to the losses you have just suffered?
The mistake of pride, Lazarus said. We are the Dark Angels. We are the first of the Adeptus Astartes. That fills us with pride, and that pride fills us with rage at the fall of our brothers. Because of our pride, we risk having the oath we made to destroy the Fallen become an obsession. And obsessions have the power to distract, to distort, to destroy.
Obsession. Azrael's voice was low. Do you believe we go too far in our fight against the nest of traitors that we birthed in our ranks?
Yes, Lazarus said.
The traitors that cost us an entire world, our world, Caliban, in a battle with our own brothers.
Yes.
Azrael stood, his chair skidding back across the black and green tiles. And you come to me with this now because of a revelation that you gleaned from a story.
Lazarus looked up at him, facing the anger in his eyes, in his face, in the set of his body.
Yes.
Azrael stared down at him, his armored hands clenching in tight fists. When you returned from Rimanok after Apothecary Asbiel had saved you by forcing you across the Rubicon Primaris, there were some who feared what your death and that strange resurrection might have done to your mind. I championed you, Lazarus, because I believed in you, in your intelligence, in your resilience, in your steadiness. I believed they would see you through, and I thought I was right, even with your troubles. After. But now, you come to me with this madness.
It is not madness, Master Azrael.
Lazarus stayed seated, but he could feel the cold anger in him again, strengthening him.
It is strategy. We must fight the Fallen. They are not just our enemies, but the enemies of all the Imperium, and of the Emperor who protects it. But we must not be so obsessed with them that we lose sight of everything else. We are surrounded by enemies, my lord, all eager to tear us down, to destroy us. And if we let our battle against the Fallen become our everything, our only thing, it will weaken us. We will make ourselves easier prey for all our enemies. And for what? To atone for our shame!
Azrael snapped out the words, his deep voice filling the room. To redeem our honor! To prove that we are worthy to serve the Emperor as his first, his oldest, his greatest legion.
All of those, Lazarus said, his voice hard and cold. And because we were afraid of having the Imperium and our brothers and the Emperor know that despite our history, our gene seed, our strength, we are still human and flawed, and that we can fail.
Azrael moved to him, a blur of motion. And Lazarus had to fight his reflexes to keep himself still. The Supreme Grand Master grasped Lazarus's armor, ceramite grating against ceramite, and hauled him up so that Azrael was glaring straight into his eyes.
We are the Adeptus Astartes. We are his chosen. We know no fear.
Lazarus looked back at him, eye to eye, unwavering, silent. Until Azrael finally let him go.
You are one of my best, brother, and one of my most challenging.
Azrael had a leash on his rage, but it was still there, coiled beneath the suddenly smooth mask of his features.
Our strategy, my strategy, will not change. The Fallen will always be our first target, our greatest goal. 10,000 years of hunting, of toil and pain, will not end because you lost four squads and one man. Do you, Understand me.
Lazarus serves as a captain of the Dark Angels chapter during the era Indomitus, serving with distinction within the 5th Company during his tenure as a sergeant. His defense of the chapter's fortress monastery, the Rock, against demonic invasion and corrupted chapter serfs, galvanized his hatred of the ruinous powers and their pawns. Inheriting the rank of captain from his slain master, Balthasar, following the emergence of the Great Rift, as the new keeper of the unseen ritual, Lazarus vowed to avenge his predecessor and lead the Unrelenting to new heights of glory. Clad in a suit of artificer armor, adorned with the spirit shield helm containing a shard of Caliban's lost stone golems, Lazarus charges into the fray, armed with the Heavenfall Blade known as Fellbane, forged from a fragment of an obsidian meteorite. Combating the Thousand Suns during the invasion of the Stygius Sector, the Sentient Horrors tested Master Lazarus's strategic brilliance, his leadership saving the Imperial forces of the Ice World of Rimnok from total annihilation. Wounded in battle by a sorcerer of chaos, no means of medical attention nor internment into a dreadnought sarcophagus could prevent his death. The only option available to the chapter to extend his mortality, the Rubicon Primaris, such a transformation was dangerous in the extreme, having cost many able-bodied Astartes their lives already. Days of surgery performed by Apothecary Asmiel tormented his physical form until Lazarus crossed the Rubicon, his zealous abhorrence of demons and heretics emboldened by his ascension. The first Primaris Marine to return to the fold of the Dark Angels' inner circle, his example led to the remainder of his kin to undergo the surgeries which would strengthen their resolve. Leading the 5th Company alongside the Chamber Militant of the Ordo Malleus, the Grey Knights, during the assault of Sortiarius, the Unrelenting thwarted the ritual of the Crimson King, Magnus the Red, to summon human psychers as slaves to his machinations. Victorious over the Changer of Ways and its malevolent plot, Lazarus's next campaign pitted his company against a horde of greenskins, which would regardless be abandoned. His forces recalled by Supreme Grandmaster Azrael to hunt a band of fallen angels, Lazarus made his opinion clear to his chapter master that such obsessions with hunting the fallen had, in his mind, diluted their purpose in defending the Imperium. Ordered by Azrael to venture to the Nightworld of Reyes, Lazarus found the planet's government and Adeptus Mechanicus officials consumed with inner turmoil, with the knightly order, House Halvan, bereft of purpose. Beset by an ancient evil known as the Gree, alongside his stalwart battle brothers, Lieutenant Zachariah, Lieutenant Ahmad, Ancient Jekun, and interrogator chaplain Demetrius, Lazarus sought a means to thwart the strange fungal mold, the Grey Pall, which imbued the populace with fell knowledge. Liberating the planet of Reyes, thanks to the sacrifice of Jekun and the mortal human Isentrude, Lazarus meditated on the loss of such noble souls as a message of hope was received from the Rock. News of the return of the Lion. Making all haste to the Fortress Monastery, Lazarus joined forces with his unforgiven peers as the armies of Vashtor the Archophane laid siege to the Rock, fighting by the side of Supreme Grandmaster Azrael to defend the Inner Sanctum. The Arcs of Omen campaign heralding the return of their indomitable Primarch. The future of Lazarus's chapter is renewed, much alike to his journey through the Rubicon Primaris. For should his brethren eschew their hunt for the fallen, his vision of the Dark Angels, once more defending the Imperium with all their might, shall herald a new era of glory for the first.